Vitis vinifera is a species of grape that most wines are made from. The genus is Vitis, the species is vinifera. One of them, say, is Pinot Noir. Pinot Noir has a myriad number of clones, and a clone can be traced back to a single bud on a single vine. Grapes are a lot like people. Every seed is going to produce a different grape. You reproduce grapevines by taking a vegetative cutting and either grafting onto a rootstock or rooting it directly, and that will be the same grape as a parent. However, on that parent vine, you also have genetic mutations. It's like finding a sport on an apple tree. Grabbing scene apples used to be big here, and there was a standard grab. The old timers talk about red grabs and black grabs. There are ones that had a different color and a slightly different flavor that grew on a tree. It was called a sport, and they took cuttings from those and grafted them and created another kind of grabbing scene apple. It's much the same with grapevines. Over time, people have taken cuttings from Pinot Noir and Burgundy and planted them, what was called selection massal, just cuttings, lots of them. And then they realized that some vines produced fruit that was more interesting than others, so they started reproducing those vines. If you can trace it back to a single bud, it is a clone of that single bud. Just as if you want to reproduce a human, you can't take an egg and get it in another person. You have to take tissue from that person with the exact same genetics and reproduce it. Clones are often confused with selections. Pinot Noir is a very good case in point. We have the Swan selection here. We do not have the Swan clone. There is a Swan clone because years ago, UC Davis got cuttings. They took one and started reproducing it. It's in their number system. It can be traced back to a single bud on a single vine within our vineyard. Our vineyard came from, we believe, cuttings from three vines that the director of the UC Davis Experimental Station, Oakville, collected from the original Palmasan plantings a million years ago. And there's no record of whether it came from one vine or all three. But we know there is variation within the Swan selection. So from the selection, somebody did collect something from one bud and they created a clone. Early days of California, Pinot Noir was planted. Years later, when Pinot Noir became something that they actually wanted to promote, the university and other people wanted to promote, they went to Europe and got selections from the propagation nurseries there. They originated in Pommard and Burgundy. That was the source material. There's also Wädenswil clones. They came from Switzerland. Over time, people were looking for new things, and lots of people made trips to Burgundy, and whether they were picking cuttings up off the floor of a vineyard that had just been pruned, or were tasting wine with somebody that gave them some cuttings, they brought selections back. And because, almost without exception, they were from a vineyard where it was not planted to one single clone. They're often named after those places, but they're not true clones. They're selections that were made from a place, and they are generally a mixture of clonal material. Swan is one that, again, we can't determine if it came from one vine or three vines. It's truly a selection, but it's one of the heritage selections. Josh Jensen of Calera brought cuttings back from one of his trips to Europe. It's called, often called the Calera clone, but it's really a selection for the same reasons. The numbers, Dijon refers to the University of Dijon, and they have a system similar to Davis where they did a lot of research and clonal selections there. And cuttings were evaluated, the vines were propagated, wine was made, and they put together a catalog with the characteristics of each of those, and they gave them a catalog number. The ones that came to Oregon and California were ones that were chosen because they tended to make high quality wines and small clusters and small berries and other attributes. And they started with three, 113, 114, and 115. And shortly thereafter, clones 667 and 777 came along, and now there's more as well. Those are from the original Dijon cataloging numbers. That's all they were, a reference number. UC Davis has their own referencing number. The people who brought the Dijon clones in, it was agreed to use the University of Dijon numbers, so there'd be less confusion. But those are the two primary sources of most Pinot Noir that's planted in the U.S., other than the suitcase selections, which means somebody smuggled it in, which is highly illegal, but was done quite a bit.